Gabriella and Evelyn Simon.
Kyle!
Love spending time with
Miss Jenny!
Miss Jenny and Miss Angie. But to find the right person to look after their kids, their parents, Jennifer and Charlie, rely on more than just a leap of faith.
So we've got a select few of babysitters that we keep on hand that we've trust.
Trust that they're good with children, trust that they have clean pasts, and in the age of COVID-19, trust that they will minimize the risk to the family.
But now I think it's changed a little bit somewhat.
I think any precaution is a good one right now.
And Stacy Pelton, absolutely, an American Red Cross babysitter, CPR, and first aid instructor, said it should.
I think that at this point, when you ask someone to come into your home, you can't ask too many questions.
Pelton said ask babysitters if they have been exposed to the virus.
I'll put the flag up.
To keep their girls safe, the Simons want to know what their babysitters have been doing while they're off duty.
You know, if they're going out to concerts or if they're going out to big congregations.
But coronavirus is not the only potential danger they screen for.
We will run their background just to make sure.
The Simons also look into any criminal history.
There's all kinds of reasons to vet a babysitter.
Montgomery County Sheriff Rob Streck said in the last 8 months, his agency has been called to 6 cases of reported babysitter abuse.
You know, I definitely think it's probably something that's underreported.
But to look into a sitter's past, to avoid these concerning situations, you have to know how to work the system.
A lot of people hire 14, 16-year-old babysitters. Is there any way to check up on their criminal history at all?
Not really.
That's because juvenile records are protected.
Did your kids fear them?
But Montgomery County Sheriff Rob Streck said young people post a lot about themselves online.
But you can still look at Facebook and Instagram and things like that. I mean, you could even ask them if you wanted to. We have done that hiring people here. We've said, hey, can we look at your social media? Because we had this question.
Investigating adults is different.
We report to BCI.
Clark County Clerk of Courts Melissa Tuttle said there is no database to track abusive babysitters.
That would really require the laws to change, that actually be something that we track.
However, you can use court records to check up on someone's criminal history.
You know, you're giving people the trust, so anything that's dealing with violence is a concern because you are trusting them with your kids. But then also you're inviting them into your home. So you're also worried about theft, whether they would come in for any other criminal activity. If there was drug abuse, you really, whatever you wouldn't want around your kids.
We really want you paying attention to our child.
And Streck said if you have the babysitter's full name, social security number, and driver's license number, the sheriff's office can run a basic background check that will show offenses in the county. That search is free. And for $40, the sheriff's office will run a background check through the state's Bureau of Criminal Investigation, but the sitter has to request it. Plus, Streck said parents can also pay a private company like LexisNexis to run a search.
It's just always a good thing to know is who is in your home and what kind of background do they have and how much can I trust them with pretty much everything that's important in my life.
And all 3 professionals I spoke to stressed the importance of interviewing babysitters before you leave them with your kids and checking references.
If you have any kind of red flags, I think that parents' knowledge of that something's happened in the past, don't risk your child's life. Try to find somebody that's better suited that can watch your child.
You want to make sure that they do have a role model that they're going to be following if we're not there.
Knowing how to protect their children when they're not there, a parent's mission made even more complex in the age of COVID-19.
In Dayton, Ohio, I'm Molly Cullick reporting.